Landslides cause about $250 to $300 million worth of damage a year in New Zealand and have caused more fatalities than any other natural hazards. And recently, Cyclone Gabriel, the damage from that was about $1.5 billion from landslides. Across the councils, we saw a patchwork of approaches to landslide hazard and risk. We didn't see many maps, and we saw that other hazards like earthquake and flood had higher priority in councils and yet possibly didn't cause as much damage or death.
So the Landslide Planning Guidance is a document that provides a blueprint for planners and how you can reduce landslide risk using land use planning. We brought together the two communities of engineering, geology and planning. We also put together a steering committee to provide advice throughout this process, and that committee consisted of members from local and central government and other organisations. Lastly, we undertook targeted engagement and sought feedback from the engineering geology profession and the planning profession.
In a perfect world, we wouldn't have any development impacted by landslides, and what this guidance does is provides the framework to take the landslide information and interpret it in a way that land use planners can apply it to our policy development, to how we zone land, through to how we make decisions around resource consents. Key message in the Landslide Planning Guidance is that land use planners incorporate landslide analysis early in their processes. We've divided the work that geotechnical and engineering geologists do into five different levels. Once we've undertaken our level A susceptibility analysis, from there we can refine the areas that we want to undertake hazard and risk analysis based on that susceptibility analysis. So we don't have to do those detailed assessments everywhere, only where they're needed. It's about the right information informing the right development in the right place.